As you know, there have been new threats, online threats every day, and there may be thousands of different types of threats. There are not many ways, there are very few steps required to protect yourself in the first place. If you use proper protective mechanisms, you can remain unharmed by many of the online threats. Let us try to understand how a virus or a rogue anti-spyware or anti-virus program affects your computer. Whenever you are browsing the internet, if you do not have Firefox and no script plugin, then most probably the website will be successful to download a harmful software on your computer. What the website does is it changes your registry, Windows registry, and creates an entry in the Windows startup to run a certain program. The browser is allowed to save downloaded files into temp directory, that is the only directory that is allowed for the browser. So these harmful websites save their executable files inside the temp directory and then create a entry in the Windows startup to run that executable file next time when the Windows starts. So when you restart the Windows after getting infected by such files, during Windows startup, the executable program will run and it again may connect to the internet and download more of such files and infect your computer further. So the best way to protect your computer is to delete all the temp files at the end of the browsing session. You can use the browser's built-in capability to delete the temp files, or you can use the Windows disk cleanup, or you can alternately use a freeware temp files cleaner like CCleaner. So it is always advisable to clean all the browser cache at the end of the browsing session in order to avoid any undetected infection. Now let us see what we can do in case of an infection. So you have to understand that in order for a program to run, you have to click on it. There may be several programs installed on your computer, but unless you go in the program menu and click on a particular program, it does not run. So how does a virus creates this trigger? How does it run without you specifying to run that program? They create an entry in Windows startup. Thereby, whenever your computer starts, the virus executes. So if you understand, if you know all the programs installed on your computer, you can very easily protect your computer from any kind of harmful software. There is a built-in tool in Windows called System Configuration Utility. If you click on Start, click on Run, type msconfig and press OK. That will open the System Configuration Utility. Then click on the Startup tab. Here you will see, whatever you will see in the first look, it will be difficult to comprehend what exactly each program is or whether it belongs to a certain program or not. The startup, there are three columns. One is called startup item. The second is the path of the executable file. And third is the location in the Windows registry. If you can figure out from the names under startup item, then it is all right. It should be quite possible to read these names and figure out which program each name belongs to. The second column gives you more detailed information, but as you can see, the path is not completely visible. To make it visible, take your mouse button between command and location, and then you can see the mouse button changes into a two-sided arrow. Press the left mouse button and you can enlarge the middle window. This will make the complete path visible and you will be easily able to read the path and figure out which program. And then take your time to study each entry in Windows startup, because this is the place where your protection lies. let us see now what is here. First entry is of Windows Defender. It is located under program files, so it is a known program. The second program is Avast, that is my antivirus. The third program is Google Talk. Next program is the firewall zone alarm. The next is, it's my audio driver. Next, there is a link scanner program that I have currently installed. It means I can recognize what is it. Next is my CCleaner program. Next is Vidalia bundle. That is the program I know what it is. Next is Yahoo Messenger. Next is Privoxy. Now you can see there is an entry which I have already disabled, which does not have any mention of any name and there is no command, but it was listed in the startup. So if you find any such names where either the startup name or the command is not given, then you can doubt that this is something harmful. So disable that program. And if you cannot figure out what that program is, then also you can disable that program, so that the next time the computer runs, that program will not start automatically. This does not uninstall that program, it simply stops that program from starting with Windows. If you need that program, you can always go in the program menu and open that program. And the settings in system configuration utility are reversible. You can open the system configuration utility again and enable any program again to start with the Windows. So don't be scared to experiment with Windows startup. Disable anything that you do not know what it is or you are doubtful about it. Disable it and see what happens. If you think by chance you have disabled anything that you need, then you can open system configuration utility again and enable the program again. That way you will be able to ward off many unwanted programs. That will also speed up your computer. So definitely disable as many programs as possible. Make it as light as possible. So what happens when you uncheck any program or make any changes in the system configuration utility? After that, the next step is to press the apply button. As soon as you press apply, there is a button called close. Press on it. The next thing that you will see is it will ask you to restart your computer. So do it. Restart your computer. After restarting, there will be a small alert from the system configuration utility. Just check it and say do not display this message again. That will be after Windows restart. That's all you need to do. Windows startup is the place where any harmful software makes its entry to start automatically. If you can manage to disable it, remove it from the Windows startup, then it will not affect your computer. Still, the program files will remain on the computer's hard disk, but it will be easier for you to detect and remove them. I will end it here. Thank you very much.